The procedure to multiply fraction is very simple to remember. You just have to multiply all the top numbers. In this case, 1 times 4 is equal 4. Then you have to divide it by the multiplication of all the bottom numbers. In this case, 2 times 3 is equal to 6. So the answer is 4 over 6. However, it is recommended to simplify any fraction if it is possible, because usually this is how in some tests or answer of the books are requested. As 4 and 6 are even numbers, both can be divided by 2. So 4 over 2 is 2 in the numerator, 6 over 2 is 3 in the denominator, and now we have the simplest form of this fraction. Because the number 2 and 3 are prime numbers, it means they don't have common factors to continue reducing more this fraction. However, you can use the first or the second fraction as the answer. Example number 2. Again, we have to multiplication of two fractions. So the procedure is the same. We have to multiply all the top numbers, then multiply all the bottom numbers. In this case, 5 times 6 is 30. 3 times 7 is 21. This is the answer of the multiplication, but always it is recommended to find common factors in fraction to simplify them if it is possible. The highest number that can be divided into 30 is 21, exactly, is the number 3. In the top, we have 30 over 3 is 10. In the bottom, we have 21 over 3 is 7. Both fractions are the same, but with smaller numbers. And if we try again moving on with simplification, we realize that it's not possible to find another common factor, since 7 is a prime number and 10 doesn't have 7 as a factor. So now we can be sure this is the simplest form of the fraction. On the other hand, 10 is bigger than 7. It means that 10 over 7 is an improper fraction, and now we can change it into a mixed fraction. Now is the moment to remember how to use the long division. In this case, how many times 7 go into 10 is 1, and 10 minus 7 is 3 as remainder. So the mixed fraction will start with a whole number, in this case is 1, and then the numerator will be the remainder, that is 3, staying with the same denominator, that is 7. As you can see, there are three ways to represent the answer of the multiplication. All of them are the correct answer. However, I suggest to use the improper form as solution, because this is the way that usually you will see on books or tests. Now, if we have to solve a multiplication with a mixed fraction by a whole number, it is recommended to change them to an improper fraction. To do this, just multiply the denominator by the whole number, then add everything to the numerator and keep the same denominator. So, in this case, 3 times 5 is equal 15, and 15 plus 2 is 17, and keep the same denominator, which is 3. For the whole part, you just divide the number by 1 and keep the same value, but now as a fraction. So with two simple fractions, we just do the same procedure of multiplication. That is, multiply all the top numbers and then multiply all the bottom numbers. In this case, 17 times 2 equals 34 over 3 times 1 equals 3, which is 34 over 3. We cannot simplify the fraction because 3 is only divided by 3 and 1, and 34 cannot be divided by 3. However, we can get an improper fraction because the numerator is greater than the denominator. The final answer of the multiplication is 34 over 3, or 11 and 1/3. A multiplication also can be represented with many brackets together. As you can see in this example, with three brackets with no operation sign, plus or minus between them, which means that all of them are multiplying each other. So always be careful when you multiply negative fraction. First, you have to multiply all the signs. Use the rule of signs in pairs. So if the first fraction doesn't have a sign, means that it's a plus. Plus times minus equals minus, so the first pair is equal to a minus. Minus times minus is equal to a plus. So we get the sign of the answer, that is a plus. working now with fraction. It doesn't matter how many fractions are. The procedure is the same, multiplying all the numerators over the multiplication of all denominators. 3 times 2 equals 6, then 6 times 1 equals 6 over 7 times 5 equals 35, then 35 times 2 equals 70. This is the answer, but both numbers are even, which means that they can be divided by 2. 6 over 2 equals 3, and 70 over 2 equals 35. And now we get the simplified fraction of our multiplication.